Hello VR shoppers, today we're going to be taking a look at Astronomy VR, available on Android and iOS. You got two options. You got VR mode on the left and just a basic 360 on rails tool that you can use on your phone if you haven't got a mobile VR headset. But of course, if we've got a mobile VR headset, we're going to click on that and we're going to insert it into our headsets.
A supernova is an astronomical event that occurs during the last stellar evolutionary stages of a massive star's life, whose dramatic and catastrophic destruction is marked by one final titanic explosion. This causes the sudden appearance of a new bright star, before slowly fading from sight over several weeks or months. Supernovae are more energetic than novae. In Latin, nova means new, referring astronomically to what appears to be a temporary new bright star. Adding the prefix super distinguishes supernovae from ordinary novae, which are far less luminous. Only three Milky Way nuclei supernova events have been observed during the last 1,000 years, though many have been seen in other galaxies using telescopes. The most recent directly observed supernova in the Milky Way was Kepler's supernova in 1604, but the remnants of two more recent supernovae have also been found. Statistical observations of supernovae in other galaxies suggest they occur on average about 3 times every century in the Milky Way, and that any galactic supernova would almost certainly be observable with modern astronomical telescopes. Gravitational waves are ripples in the curvature of space-time that propagate as waves at the speed of light, generated in certain gravitational interactions that propagate outward from their source. In 1905, Henri Poincaré first proposed gravitational waves, ondes gravifiques, emanating from a body and propagating at the speed of light as being required by the Lorentz transformations. Predicted in 1916 by Albert Einstein on the basis of his theory of general relativity, gravitational waves transport energy as gravitational radiation, a form of radiant energy similar to electromagnetic radiation. Gravitational waves cannot exist in the Newton's law of universal gravitation, since it is predicated on the assumption that physical interactions propagate at infinite speed. Gravitational wave astronomy is an emerging branch of observational astronomy which aims to use gravitational waves to collect observational data about sources of detectable gravitational waves such as binary star systems composed of white dwarfs, neutron stars, and black holes, and events such as supernovae, and the formation of the early universe shortly after the Big Bang. Dark matter is an unidentified type of matter distinct from dark energy, baryonic matter, ordinary matter, and neutrinos whose existence would explain a number of otherwise puzzling astronomical observations. The name refers to the fact that it does not emit or interact with electromagnetic radiation, such as light, and is thus invisible to the entire electromagnetic spectrum. Although dark matter has not been directly observed, its existence and properties are inferred from its gravitational effects such as the motions of visible matter, gravitational lensing, its influence on the universe's large-scale structure, on galaxies, and its effects in the cosmic microwave background. The dark matter hypothesis plays a central role in current modeling of cosmic structure formation and galaxy formation and evolution and on explanations of the anisotropies observed in the cosmic microwave background, CMB. All these lines of evidence suggest that galaxies, galaxy clusters, and the universe as a whole contain far more matter than that which is observable via electromagnetic signals. Many experiments to detect proposed dark matter particles through non-gravitational means are underway. However, no dark matter particle has been conclusively identified. Gravity, or gravitation, is a natural phenomenon by which all things with mass are brought toward, or gravitate toward, one another, including planets, stars, and galaxies. Since energy and mass are equivalent, all forms of energy, including light, also cause gravitation and are under the influence of it. On Earth, gravity gives weight to physical objects and causes the ocean tides. The gravitational attraction of the original gaseous matter present in the universe caused it to begin coalescing, forming stars, and the stars to group together into galaxies. So gravity is responsible for many of the large-scale structures in the universe. gravity has an infinite range, although its effects become increasingly weaker on farther objects. Gravity is most accurately described by the general theory of relativity, proposed by Albert Einstein in 1915, which describes gravity not as a force, but as a consequence of the curvature of space-time caused by the uneven distribution of mass, energy. An eclipse is an astronomical event that occurs when an astronomical object is temporarily obscured, either by passing into the shadow of another body or by having another body pass between it and the viewer. An eclipse occurs during a syzygy. The term eclipse is most often used to describe either a solar eclipse, when the moon's shadow crosses the Earth's surface, or a lunar eclipse, when the moon moves into the Earth's shadow. However, it can also refer to such events beyond the Earth-Moon system, for example, a planet moving into the shadow cast by one of its moons, a moon passing into the shadow cast by its host planet, or a moon passing into the shadow of another moon. A binary star system can also produce eclipses if the plane of the orbit of its constituent stars intersects the observer's position. A black hole is a region of space-time exhibiting such strong gravitational effects that nothing, not even particles and electromagnetic radiation such as light, can escape from inside it. The theory of general relativity predicts that a sufficiently compact mass can deform space-time to form a black hole. The boundary of the region from which no escape is possible is called the event horizon. Although the event horizon has an enormous effect on the fate and circumstances of an object crossing it, no locally detectable features appear to be observed. In many ways, a black hole acts like an ideal black body, as it reflects no light. Moreover, quantum field theory in curved space-time predicts that event horizons emit Hawking radiation, with the same spectrum as a black body of a temperature inversely proportional to its mass. This temperature is on the order of billionths of a Kelvin for black holes of stellar mass, making it essentially impossible to observe. Despite its invisible interior, the presence of a black hole can be inferred through its interaction with other matter and with electromagnetic radiation such as visible light. Matter that falls onto a black hole can form an external accretion disk heated by friction, forming some of the brightest objects in the universe. If there are other stars orbiting a black hole, their orbits can be used to determine the black hole's mass and location. Such observations can be used to exclude possible alternatives such as neutron stars. In this way, astronomers have identified numerous stellar black hole candidates in binary systems, and established that the radio source known as Sagittarius A, at the core of our own Milky Way galaxy, contains a supermassive black hole of about 4.3 million solar masses. In physics, space-time is a mathematical model that combines space and time into a single interwoven continuum. Until the turn of the 20th century, the assumption had been that the 3D geometry of the universe, its description in terms of locations, shapes, distances, and directions, was distinct from time, the measurement of when events occur within the universe. However, Albert Einstein's 1905 special theory of relativity postulated that the speed of light through empty space has one definite value, a constant that is independent of the motion of the light source. Einstein's equations precisely described important consequences of this fact. Both the shape of space and the measurement of time simultaneously change for observers who have different relative velocities, which is to say, for observers who have different inertial frames of reference. In 1908, Hermann Minkowski, expanding upon Einstein's work, presented a geometric interpretation of special relativity that fused time and the three spatial dimensions of space into a single four-dimensional continuum, what mathematicians call a four-dimensional manifold. A key feature of this interpretation is the definition of a space-time interval that combines distance and time. Although measurements of distance and time between events differ among observers, the space-time interval is independent of the inertial frame of reference in which they are recorded. The resultant space-time came to be known as Minkowski space. Earth movements. Earth's rotation is the rotation of the planet Earth around its own axis. The Earth rotates from the west towards east. As viewed from North Star or Pole Star Polaris, the Earth turns counterclockwise.
The North Pole, also known as the geographic North Pole or terrestrial North Pole, is the point in the northern hemisphere where the Earth's axis of rotation meets its surface. This point is distinct from the Earth's North Magnetic Pole. The South Pole is the other point where the Earth's axis of rotation intersects its surface, in Antarctica. The Earth rotates once in about 24 hours with respect to the Sun and once every 23 hours, 56 minutes and 4 seconds with respect to the stars. Earth's rotation is slowing slightly with time, thus, a day was shorter in the past. This is due to the tidal effects the Moon has on Earth's rotation. Atomic clocks show that a modern day is longer by about 1.7 milliseconds than a century ago, slowly increasing the rate at which UTC is adjusted by leap seconds. Analysis of historical astronomical records shows a slowing trend of 2.3 milliseconds per century since the 8th century BCE. Earth's orbit is the path through which the Earth travels around the Sun. The average distance between the Earth and the Sun is 149.60 million kilometers, 92.96 million miles, 1, and a complete orbit occurs every 365.256 days, one sidereal year, during which time Earth travels 940 million kilometers, 584 million miles. Earth's orbital motion gives an apparent movement of the Sun with respect to other stars at a rate of about 1 degree per day, or a Sun or Moon diameter every 12 hours, eastward as seen from Earth. NB1, Earth's orbital speed averages about 30 kilometers per second, 108,000 kilometers per hour, 67,000 miles per hour, which is fast enough to cover the planet's diameter in 7 minutes and the distance to the Moon in 4 hours. Reviewed from a vantage point above the north poles of both the Sun and the Earth would appear to revolve in a counterclockwise direction about the Sunday from the same vantage point. Both the Earth and the Sun would appear to rotate in a counterclockwise direction about their respective axes. A supernova is an astronomical event that occurs during the last stellar evolutionary stages of a massive star's life, whose dramatic and catastrophic destruction is marked by one final titanic explosion. This causes the sudden appearance of a new bright star, before slowly fading from sight over several weeks or months. Supernovae are more energetic than novae. In Latin, nova means new, referring astronomically to what appears to be a temporary new bright star. Adding the prefix super distinguishes supernovae from ordinary novae, which are far less luminous. Only 3 Milky Way naked eye supernova events have been observed during the last 1,000 years, though many have been seen in other galaxies using telescopes. The most recent directly observed supernova in the Milky Way was Kepler's supernova in 1604, but the remnants of 2 more recent supernovae have also been found. Statistical observations of supernovae in other galaxies suggest they occur on average about 3 times every century in the Milky Way, and that any galactic supernova would almost certainly be observable with modern astronomical telescopes.
Wow, there you go. I have no idea half of what she said. I heard black holes and eclipse, but the rest I kind of nodded off at. It's very advanced stuff, I've got to be honest. But it has to be said that some of the 3D really does look pretty impressive, even though the frame rate's a little bit low. But visually, it's quite good. Anyway, please do visit the website link in the description box below for full review and download links. And please do click that thumbs up button if you enjoyed this video. Whether you give it a thumbs up or a thumbs down, please do leave a comment in the box below, as your feedback is essential in helping this channel grow. As always, thanks for watching. And if you've got a real deep interest in astronomy, maybe this is the app for you.